Hello everyone, Chris Laskowski back with you from C-Vision Productions. This time I want to take you back to the years 1998 and 1999 and show you in full length my personal favorite program I produced. It is titled From the Twin Ports to the Twin Cities, BNSF's Hinckley Subdivision. It is a line that runs from Superior, Wisconsin to Minneapolis, Minnesota. Not only does BNSF operate on this line, but it also hosts trackage rights trains from Canadian Pacific and Union Pacific. Back in this time period, it also ran haulage rights trains from Canadian National before they purchased the Wisconsin Central. So much was captured back before the turn of the century, as post-merger locomotives were very common, making this stretch of railroad like no other. Santa Fe, Burlington Northern, Chicago and Northwestern, Southern Pacific, Soo Line, Duluth, Winnipeg and Pacific, and Conrail locomotives were seen frequently, along with many leased units. Older power, in the forms of SD38-2s, C30-7s, SD40-2s, C40-8s, and many others were being used on a regular basis. So let's turn the clock back to the late 1990s as we present From the Twin Ports to the Twin Cities, BNSF's Hinckley Subdivision. And if you like what you see, let us know in the comments, and please feel free to subscribe to our channel. Thank you for watching. Boylston is the official north end of the Hinckley Sub. The Lake Sub from Superior to Grand Forks, North Dakota is the other line that joins here. Our first train is Union Pacific's freight from Kansas City to the UP yard in Itasca, which is near Superior. Mergers have played a difference in the trains operating on this line. All UP trains that traverse the Hinckley Sub are former Chicago and Northwestern trains. The same scenario goes for Canadian Pacific trains. Those are former Soo Line trains. Canadian National Train 341 is next through Boylston. This train will stop at Pokegama Yard near Superior before heading up the old Duluth, Winnipeg and Pacific line to International Falls. From there, the train will travel on original CN track to Winnipeg. Just south of Boylston, the tracks span over the Nemadji River. This bridge is an old Soo Line bridge. Burlington Northern bought the structure in 1988 and rerouted the Hinckley line onto it. This resulted in the BN dismantling the old GN bridge up the river. Our first train over the bridge is an all-rail taconite train coming off the Lake Sub and onto the Hinckley Sub. Led by an Oakway leased SD60, the locomotive consist also includes BNSF's SD60M number 9297 in its experimental heritage paint. A Northwestern SD40-2 was in charge of a loaded potash train. The Canadian National transferred these loads to the UP at Pakegama Yard. One of the largest bridges on the line spans the Black River. This bridge is only a few miles south of the Nemadji River. A premium Heritage SD70 Mac leads an empty Superior coal train over the structure. Crossing the border into Minnesota, we encounter another river crossing, this one in the tiny town of Holyoke. This bridge carries trains over a branch of the South Fork Nemadji River. A Canadian National train slowly approaches the bridge. The engineer brings the train to a stop to await a track inspector to clear his warrant before the train can continue on to Pakegama Yard near Superior.
Thank you.
A BNSF Northtown to Superior train rolls past a county road crossing north of Nickerson. We set up for an oncoming meet in the tiny community of Nickerson. This is a very quiet town with only a few residences. The old town hall still stands, but it is on blocks and will soon be moved. A Santa Fe GP20 is in charge of a detoured Northtown to Grand Forks train. This train usually travels the Staple Sub from Minneapolis to Fargo and up to Grand Forks via the Hillsboro Sub. At the south end of Nickerson Siding, a loaded UP taconite train awaits a Canadian Pacific grain train. This ex-Sioux Line train is led today by a Sioux SD60M. Next, we set up in the small community of Carrick. The local bank and post office is our backdrop for a Lorem work train.
Thank you.
South of Bruno, three GP20s are in charge of a northtown to Superior manifest train on a cold February afternoon. Cobb is the home of the only depot remaining on the Hinckley Subdivision. This old Great Northern structure is still used today. It was donated by the Great Northern to the Pine County Historical Society in 1969 and is now a museum. Although it would be nice to have a GN train roll by, we settle for a UP train instead. Just east of Sandstone, another large river crossing is encountered. This one spans the Kettle River. Cautiously rolling over the bridge is an extra Union Pacific train powered by CN, DWP, and Norfolk Southern locomotives. The midpoint of the subdivision is here at Hinckley. It is also here that the BNSF transfers freight with shortline St. Croix Valley. Seen here, the St. Croix Valley train is coming into Hinckley from the south on the main line. It is returning from the town of Mora, which is 11 miles from Mora Junction on the main line. The St. Croix Valley also serves the ex-Northern Pacific line that runs south from Hinckley to North Branch. The St. Croix Valley train slowly approaches the switch that will lead it into the yard south of town. The BNSF Hinckley local is already in the yard preparing to interchange freight before heading back to Northtown Yard in Minneapolis. South of Hinckley, a C-30-7 leads an empty coal train. After the UPSP merger, many Southern Pacific units began showing up on this line. At Brook Park, an SP Jeep 60 is in charge of train MDMIT. A little west of Brook Park is Mora Junction. This is where the St. Croix Valley splits off the main line to Mora. Coming around the curve, a C-30-7 and two SD9s haul a BNSF Northtown to Superior manifest. Yet another northbound to Superior train makes its way past our camera, this one in the town of Henriette. Two of Canadian Pacific's AC-4400s leads its grain train into the siding at Graston. It is preparing to meet an empty coal train with extra power heading to Northtown Yard.
On the other side of the siding at Graston, we await a loaded taconite train. The clouds give us a great scene of the setting sun as we wait for the train. From a county road overpass just south of Stanchfield, another SP power set shows up on a Kansas City to Itasca train. Another small town setting is laid out for us for our next run by. The town of Grandy sets on Highway 65. Small businesses and the post office still serve the locals and witness many trains passing on the main line, including this northbound CN train. In Cambridge, we view a CN meet. The southbound train is led with two Duluth, Winnipeg, and Pacific SD40s. Bethel is our next stop. Adjacent to the main line is the Independent Locomotive Services Shop. This facility repairs and paints locomotives from all over the system. They also lease locomotives that are rebuilt from many other railroads, including the BNSF and the Duluth-Mesabian Iron Range. The storage track at ILS can easily be mistaken for a museum, with many old locomotives waiting to be repaired or scrapped. The Santa Fe B23-7 is in charge of a Northtown to Superior train just north of the town of Cedar. In Cedar, another CN train heads north. This train carries symbol number 347, which is destined to Winnipeg. Thank you. Just south of Cedar in the community of Oak Grove, we catch train UBRMHAS heading south. We now jump ahead a couple miles south to view four movements. The first is a loaded Union Pacific potash train with a C40-8 in charge. At the north end of Andover Siding, we get a chance to see a four-train meet. The meet includes a train from all four railroads that were operating on the line at the time of production. Thank you. After awaiting all three trains, CP train 203 gets the light out of Andover. Led by a Sioux SD40-2, this train is a general freight from St. Paul Yard to Superior. Coming into the suburb of Coon Rapids, the Conrail unit is in charge of Union Pacific train MITDM. Coon Creek is the southern end of the Hinckley Subdivision. Coon Creek is 7 miles north of Northtown Yard in the suburb of Coon Rapids. It is here that the Hinckley Sub joins the double-tracked Staple Sub. This is a fairly busy spot on the BNSF and is documented in the C-Vision release, The Creek. A loaded BNSF taconite train is the first to come through the creek, led with a pair of Burlington Northern SD60Ms. Thank you. Three SD90s lead a Union Pacific taconite train through the creek. One of BNSF's newly delivered Dash 9s heads a Superior to Northtown train. This unit was put into service before the lettering and striping were applied. Our show doesn't end here. In August of 1998, the BNSF ran an employee special behind Milwaukee Road steam locomotive number 261. We get our first look at this train as it passes Moore Junction. The train is on its way to the Twin Ports. It is stopping here so that the conductor can realign the switch back to the main line. A previous train left the switch aligned to the siding while clearing for the special. After taking water and grease in Hinckley, the 261 throttles up and continues on to Superior. While waiting for the employee special north of Askov, a southbound detoured grain train makes its way by while the 261 awaits in the siding in town.